Welcome back, Linux enthusiasts. In today's video, we'll dive into an incredibly useful feature of Systemd called Systemd.debug-shell. This is a powerful tool designed to help you troubleshoot and diagnose the issue that may arise during the boot process of your Linux system. But why should you use the debug shell? Well, imagine encountering a problem during the boot time where your system fails to start the cross-shell service. Experience a network connectivity issue or encounter hardware-related errors. This situation can be frustrating and time-consuming to troubleshoot, especially without a dedicated tool. So there is where Systemd.debug-shell comes to rescue. By enabling this feature, you can gain access to the debug shell during the boot process, allowing you to interactively investigate and resolve this problem. Now let's go ahead and see some practical example. So let me send a key that is Ctrl-Alt-Delete that will ultimately reboot this virtual machine. But instead of that, you can also click on this button and click on the reboot. So typically we can do something like Ctrl-Alt+Delete button. So here we are able to select a kernel. So let's go with the default one. So as you can see, we are stuck on the boot process and it is go on to the emergency mode. We don't need to have a root account because systemd.debug-shell will open the root shell on the TTY9. So let me just go ahead and reboot this once again, and we are going to enable it at the runtime from the kernel parameter. So there are a couple of ways for enabling the systemd.debug-shell. One is you can just simply use the systemctl command when you are logging onto your desktop environment. And another one is you can set the systemd.debug-shell kernel parameter when you are just booting into the system. So let me just go ahead and show you. And let me just go on to the end of the line. And on the here, we can set the systemd.debug-shell. Okay, so this is how it should set. And we can just simply press the Ctrl X in order to start the boot process. So we are on the rescue, and at this moment, you can just simply press the Ctrl, Alt, and F9. I think it's Ctrl, Alt, F9. Okay. In my case, I can just simply send the keys input from my hypervisor. So on the, if you are working on the real system and the bare metal hardware, then you can just simply press the Ctrl, Alt, and F9 on your keyboard. So boom, and we got the root shell spawn on your TTY9. So from here, you can just debug your errors that arise during the system boot. So you can, on the typical system, you can do like systemctl list-jobs. And just simply go ahead and check for the fs tab. I have intentionally created a simple error. So that is just by giving the wrong file system type. So we can just go on to the /fs tab file and comment this line because this was the intentional error. Okay, now we can just simply reboot. Okay, on here you can just use the basic system commands in order to debug your system and in order to fix the error. So that is how you use the debug shell. There is another way that you can enable the debug shell when you need, but I don't think that is the recommended one, just by using the systemctl enable debug shell. Let me just check the status first. What it does is it will just enable the systemd.debug-shell for forever. So that is not how it should be, because leaving your root shell without the encrypted or the without the root password on the TTY9 can be the dangerous, because anyone can access it if they got your system. So if you get the root account, root shell to anyone that is anonymous or that is unknown, then they can just misconfigure your system, or they can just break your system, or they will just gain access to your system. So that is not the recommended way for enabling the debug shell. Instead of that, you can just leave the debug shell as a max service. For that, you can just simply do the systemctl max debug-shell. So that is how you max the debug shell on the systemd. Okay, so when you are just done debugging your system boot errors, you can just simply disable the debug shell or you tell from the kernel parameter, it will just automatically disable when you are done or the when you reboot the system. So let me just go ahead and reboot this once again because we have already fixed the error. And we are on. And let me try once by sending the Ctrl Alt and F9 if it is there or not. Okay. So it's not there. Yeah, it's not there. And let me go on to my account. It's really huge. Okay. Now let's go ahead and check for the systemctl status debug shell. So as you can see, it's inactive. So that is how you use the systemd debug shell. Just always remember that enabling the systemd debug shell from the systemctl and leaving it open when you are not using can be dangerous. So always make sure that you have disabled it when you are done debugging. So that is most for the tutorial, and I hope you find this video very useful. So please like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel.